There was a time in the history of the world, we know that the Jewish people were first chosen to be vehicle of righteousness. And they failed. In fact, they failed so miserably, and it's very sad. Have you ever seen any Jew propagating his deed to somebody else? No, because they say their religion is meant for them alone. They are the chosen people. Everybody else is a Gentile. In their books, not only the five books of Moses, but in their other commentary books, they say they are the chosen people. Allah loved them so much more than anybody else. Allah loved you also, you love the Gentile, but he kind of loved them more, you know? Allah loved us, okay, but he loves them more because they are the chosen people. Now, why would Allah choose you? Allah chose them what? To present this message, and they failed. They failed so miserably. Moses in the, you know, in the Ten Commandments, and he actually chastised them. He said, "You stiff neck, you wicked, you adulterous generation, you stiff neck, you defiant, you this Moses." It's unbelievable. He said, "Look, I am with you today, and look at how you are behaving. Imagine if I'm not with you, what's going to happen to you, O Israel?" And on the invective that he gave to Israel. Jesus did the same thing. "Oh, you vipers, oh, you rotten sepulcher, you adulterous generation, you wicked, you this and that. How long shall you escape the damnation of God? Oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how long have I spent time with you, gathering you like a hen does to her chick, yet you slip away, you violent and wicked generation. The kingdom of God, O Jerusalem, will be taken away from you, not shall, will be taken away from you, and it will be given to a nation, and this nation will bring the fruit thereof. Because the stone that you have rejected, O Israel, upon this stone will be built the foundation of true foundation of God Almighty." This is the book of Matthew. He said, "The kingdom of God, O Jerusalem, will be taken away from you, and it will be given to a nation, and this nation will bring the fruit of the kingdom of God on earth." And so he spent his time praying for the kingdom of God, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth." He's praying for the kingdom of God to come. But unfortunately, he did not leave on this earth to see the kingdom of God. But we know he spent all of his time praying for the kingdom of God to come, meaning at the time that he existed, there was no kingdom of God. So he said, "This kingdom of God will be taken away from the Jewish people and be given to be transferred to a nation. And this nation will bring the fruits." I want you to put in your mind the word nation and fruits. Don't forget, nation and fruits. That's what Jesus said. The kingdom of God will be taken away from you, for sure. You read the word will, that means no doubt is going out of you, Jerusalem. "And shall be given to a nation, and this nation will bring the fruits of the kingdom of God." This is the book of Matthew, chapter 12, verse 21, verse 42. Jesus makes this equation. And he said, "The stone that you rejected, O Jerusalem, upon this stone shall be the kingdom of God." So what is he talking about when he says the stone that you rejected? Of course, Israel rejected many people. Everybody else is a Gentile. Gentile, in a Jewish language or in Hebrew, it means unclean, goy. The word Gentile in Hebrew is goy. Goy means unclean. Anyone that is not a Jew is unclean according to the Jewish system. So all of us here, we are Gentiles. And according to the Jewish people, we are goy. Why? Because God doesn't kind of like us. He loves us, he created us, but he loved them more. So we are Gentile. So in Judaism, there is no second class Judaism. There is the first class. The first class is the Jewish religion itself, the so-called Jewish people. And the second class is empty. There's no second class Jew. No, there's no second class Jew. But there is a third class Jew. Anybody else who wants to accept the religion will join, but you are a third class. Because if you are second class, you're very close to them. You're coming up to catch up with them. Eventually, you might engage to become the first. No, there's no second class. It is always the Jew and the tenth class Jew. This is in their books. They look down upon everybody else. Anytime they see you and I, "Oh, look at these people. They are doomed to hell because God chose us and he made them Gentiles." They're still thinking that way. But Jesus warned them, "No, no, Jerusalem, it will be taken away from you." Now, I want to analyze this word of Jesus, in the book of Matthew, and see if the Jewish, if actually the kingdom of God was taken away from them. Jesus made this statement according to our understanding within the history line. He made this statement less than a year before he left the earth. Now, when he said the stone that you rejected, what does he mean by the stone? This, we know Jesus Christ did not speak English. He did not speak Chinese or Japanese. He spoke Aramaic, which is the colloquial of Hebrew. In Aramaic, the word stone is Hegar. Hegar. In Arabic, Hajara. Hajara, the mother of Ishmael. She was rejected. She and her son were rejected as foreigners, as a non-entity. So Allah told Father Abraham to take Ishmael and his mother away from his household, because Allah is going to place them in a different situation and is going to bless them. So Abraham prayed to Allah selfishly after Ishmael left the camp. And the Bible did not tell us what prayers did Abraham did, but the Quran did tell us what kind of prayer Abraham did. But the Bible gave us the answer to the prayers by God Almighty. And this can be found in the book of Genesis. Genesis chapter 17, verse 20. We hear the prayers of Abraham answered. What did Allah say? God said, "Behold, O Abraham, as for Ishmael, I have heard thee. I will make him a great nation. I will multiply him exceedingly, and he will beget kings and queens from his loin, and he will become like the stars in the heaven. And I will bless him again, because he is your seed." Now, this is a beautiful prophecy. And God said, "You will bless Ishmael. He will make him a great nation." Jesus said, "The kingdom of God will be taken away from you and be given to a nation." Genesis said, "I will make him a nation, and he will become fruitful." The fruits of the kingdom is what I'm talking about. But Jesus said, he will, you know, and that nation will bear the fruits. And Allah repeated again. So you ask them, did Allah actually bless Ishmael in one way or the other? They say, well, yeah, you know, he was an archer, and he was dwelling in the bush. He became a hunter, and that's it. Full stop. Is this a blessing? Is this the stars in the heaven? Is this a great nation? Is this, I will make him from his loin will come kings and queens? Now I want you to look at the Middle East. This is the fruit of Ishmael. He became a great nation. How many nations in the kingdom of, you know, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, Qatar, Bahrain, you know, Sudan, Somalia, and on and on and on. You come, and out of them you have kings and queens. This prophecy, Allah have fulfilled this prophecy to the letter, to the children of Ishmael. And out of them came Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Out of them came Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the greatest. And Muhammad came and established the kingdom of God. Because in the book of Daniel, chapter 2, verse 41, it reads, listen carefully to the book of Daniel. God Almighty was telling Daniel something. So God said to Daniel, "There shall be a time, O Daniel, that I, God Almighty, I will rise up a kingdom from among these kings." And if you read below, it's talking about the kingdom of Persia, the kingdom of Babylon, the kingdom of Syria, the kingdom of Philistine. These are the four kingdom that God is talking to, or Daniel. "That out of this kingdom, I will rise up a greater kingdom, and this kingdom will swallow them all. And this kingdom shall not be ruled by anybody else. And this kingdom will establish justice and the law of God upon this nation that I've just mentioned. Now today, tell me, Iraq, history, Babylon, which kingdom is ruling Iraq today? They said, how about Muhammad, they were the first to open Iraq, Babylon. They threw away the gods or the worshiping of this idol, and they established it with Khilafah. They left the army with them, now they are Muslim. So God said, out of this kingdom, I will rise another kingdom and it will destroy all these four kingdoms and establish the kingdom of God upon them. So you tell me, which kingdom is the one you're actually? Dominant Muslims. Syria, which kingdom? It's Muslims. Palestine, which kingdom? Muslims. Persia, which is Iraq, which kingdom? Muslims. So you ask, did Allah actually fulfill this commandment? Yes, he did. With a twist to it too. They are Muslims. Kingdom of God. And nobody will rule them. The verse continues by saying, and nobody will rule them forever. It is true. Nobody ever ruled the Arabian kingdom from the very beginning. As written by Ramakrishna, an Indian intellectual. In his book, he said, the Arabs, nobody is interested in ruling them. He said, the Arabs, the Egyptians passed them by, the Phoenicians passed them by, the Armenians passed them by. No one is interested in ruling the Arabs. To rule them is liability. Nobody ever ruled them. How could you rule them in Cape Town by yourself? They are warriors. They are fighters. Sword. Simple statement between brother and brother. Water, a bucket of water would create a war between two brothers and everybody would build the sword. So lawlessness was the order of the day. So he said, no one is interested in ruling the Arabs. These Arabs, they walk in the desert barefooted, goat herders. To rule them is liability. And so therefore they weep and wander in the desert. Nobody is interested in ruling them. And he said, out of their midst have risen one single human being. When he came, the way they eat, he said it's wrong. The way they talk, he said it's wrong. The way they worship, he said it's wrong. Who is that? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Within 25 years, the world has never seen such a transformation. Within 25 years, this man, single-handedly, was able to sew them together and they become one. Throw all the gods that they hold with the banner, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.